And now, here on AMTV, it's time to unbox a haul of Big Finish box sets.
Hello there everybody, it's Adam Martin here and welcome to this very special video. Now, anyone who's a Doctor Who fan probably knows the name Big Finish. Big Finish is an audio production company that has been making Doctor Who related audio adventures since the late 1990s. And I've been getting into Big Finish over the past few years, and I try and buy from Big Finish where I can because they're a small company and that helps them out, but I do also like to find a good deal. And the other day I got very lucky on the Facebook Marketplace and picked up a bunch of releases for a killer price, which I'll get to at the end, but I thought I'd take you through what I picked up. You got these three box sets here, and then this box where there's about 10 box sets in it, so there's lots of box sets to get through, all Big Finish, so let's get started. So first up we have this, The Churchill Years. This came out in early 2016 and features the wonderful Ian McNeice as Winston Churchill. I'm sure some of you might remember him in the Matt Smith episode, Victory of the Daleks. And if you're new to Big Finish, this is one thing they do so well. They take characters that were like one-offs or regular like appearances here and there and they give them their own series. I think it's an absolutely fantastic idea, and on the cover you can see there's Daleks and silhouettes of the 9th, 10th and 11th Doctors. That's because the actors don't actually feature, but I'll get on to that. So yeah, The Churchill Years, this one was really cool to pick up. It's got the four stories there, which is The Oncoming Storm, which is Churchill and the 9th Doctor, Hounded, which is Churchill and the 10th Doctor, Living History, which is Churchill and the 11th Doctor, and the Chartwell Metamorphosis, which to my knowledge doesn't have a Doctor, but you know, that's still pretty cool. So four Churchill adventures there, all on four CDs, and it's brand new factory sealed. And I'll say that now, for all these things I picked up, they are all brand new factory sealed, as if I'd ordered them from Big Finish themselves. So that is the first release. Next, we have a fan favorite, River Song, and this is the Diary of River Song. Now, this is series four. Sadly, there wasn't, you know, series one available, but at the price these were going for, again, I had to pick this up. So this is Alex Kingston as a character of a song who first appeared in 2008 and last appeared on TV in 2015. And ever since 2016, I think, they've been doing series after series about River and going through her timeline. And it seems in this one, she crosses with Tom Baker's fourth Doctor, which is a pretty cool idea. This one, again, has four stories. So you've got Time in a Bottle, Kings of Infinite Space, Whodunit, and Someone I Once Knew. And this is, again, on four CDs, brand new factory sealed. And let me know in the comments, do I have to listen to Diary of River Song in like chronological season order, or can I just sort of dip in and out to whatever season I choose? Let me know in the comments below. But to complement season four, I also managed to pick up Diary of River Song series five. Now, as you can see, this seems to feature River encountering four different versions of the Master. You've got Michelle Gomez's Missy, you've got Eric Roberts, Master from the TV movie, you've got Derek Jacobi as the War Master, as he's now known, and Jeffrey Beavers as the Master, sort of the Keeper of Traken era. This again is four stories, which are The Bechdel Test, Animal Instinct, The Lifeboat and the Deathboat, and Concealed Weapon, across four CDs, brand new, factory sealed. So yeah, really nice to have two editions of the River Song series. It's one I've been curious about. I really enjoy Alex's performance as River. But again, let me know in the comments, do I have to go chronologically, or are these sets sort of the things you can dip into here and there? So those were the sets that couldn't fit in the shoebox. Now we must get into the shoebox itself. Oh boy, where do we start? I'll reach at the back. We'll start with this. This is the First Doctor Adventures Volume 4, starring David Bradley as his version of the First Doctor. And what I really love about this series is it features the actors who portrayed Ian Barber and Susan in the Adventures in Space and Time docudrama. So you've got Claudia Grant, Jamie Glover, and Gemma Powell. Really cool there. This is Volume 4. Again, 1, 2, 3 wasn't available, but again, it was all about the price it was going for. And I do want to listen to all of the First Doctor adventures with this cast at some point. There is two stories to this. You have Return to Skaro and you have Last of the Romanovs. And I'm sure you can guess from the first one, it does indeed feature the Daleks. This did come out this year, I think, and it is on two CDs, which is really nice as well. So yeah, nice to have some First Doctor in the collection. And now we're going to move into the Time War, specifically Gallifrey. This is Gallifrey Time War Volume 2. And as you can see, Lala Ward is on the cover there as Romana. And yeah, Gallifrey is an interesting series. I tried listening to the mainline from series one because it was on offer at Big Finish recently. And I don't know what it was. I just really couldn't get into the early Gallifrey stuff from like 2004. However, what I do love and am fascinated by is the whole Time War era. So I was more than willing to give the series a chance in the Time War context. This is volume two of the series. And it contains four stories. It contains Havoc, Partisans, Collateral, and Assassins. And it is in this sort of dual fat box style. It's not in individual CDs. I'm aware Big Finish have been doing that a lot more to save on production costs. It is a shame each story doesn't get, you know, its own CD with its own cover art. But if it means the guys can save money, and I guess when you're buying off Big Finish, make things a little bit cheaper, more power to them. And funnily enough, to complement Gallifrey Time War Series 2, here is Gallifrey Time War Series 3, which is really cool. Lyle Ward's there again, and Louise Jameson features as well as Leela, which is pretty cool. And you've got a Dalek in the background as well. So yeah, the Time War adventures continue for the Gallifrey team in four more stories. You've got Hostiles, Nevernaw, Mother Tongue, and Unity. So yeah, really cool again. Brand new, factory sealed. In terms of the Gallifrey Time War series, obviously Volume 1 is not included in this bundle that I got. And Gallifrey Time War Volume 4 will be out fairly soon, I think. So I've got ample time to find a Volume 1 and catch up on this series. And from what I've heard, yes, some characters from the Gallifrey series, because there's six series before this, do pop up. But I think because it's in the Time War, you can listen to Time War stuff sort of on its own too. And now we're moving on to some Eighth Doctor material. And we will start with this one, which is Ravenous. This is Ravenous 2. So with the Eighth Doctor stuff, he's had a few series on box set, starting with Dark Eyes and then Doom Coalition. I don't have any of those here, but I do have Ravenous 2. You've got a Vok robot from the Robots of Death. That's pretty cool. And his two companions. This is a nice box set. You have four stories, which is Escape from Kaldor, Better Watch Out, Fairy Tale of Salzburg, and Seizure. And this is when they were still doing their own individual CDs, which is nice. So they all get their own individual cover. Brand new factory seal, Ravenous 2. We're going to have some more Ravenous now. There seems to be the jokingly curse of this box set. There's no volume 1 to anything. But, you know, it doesn't matter. Here we have Ravenous 3, the continuation of the series. And I can see Alex Kingston is River Song there, so she must pop up. You've got India Fisher on the far left as Charlie Pollard. So Matt, that'd be nice to see how she features in it. And you've got other characters on it as well. Flipping round, you've got the four stories. You've got Deep Time Frontier, you've got Companion Piece, you've got Legend spelled out there, and you've got the odds again. So yeah, nice to have Ravenous 3 in the collection, build up my Ravenous library. And to finish off, we have Ravenous 4 as well, which is a nice addition. Again, shame there's no Ravenous 1, but you know, beggars can't be choosers, can they? Flipping this on over, this again has four different stories. You have Whisper, Planet of Dust, and I say four, Day of the Master, but I believe Day of the Master is in two parts. Yeah, see, you've got the four individual CDs, and Day of the Master Part 1 and 2 is on there. The camera's not focusing. There it is, Day of the Master Part 1 and Part 2. So yeah, really cool to have three releases in the Ravenous series, and considering how much these box sets typically go for new or sometimes on eBay, again, all to be revealed at the end, but the price I got them for is to die for. And we come right up to date with this one, Doctor Who Stranded 1. Now, this did release in 2020, I believe, and it's the start of a brand new series box set, the premise being that the Doctor and his companions are basically stranded on Earth in the year 2020. The great irony is this was obviously written and recorded well before the pandemic that's going on, so I doubt the pandemic features in this, but it wouldn't surprise me if when they do Stranded 2, 3, 4, if they haven't planned it already, that they include that, because I mean, if you're doing a story in 2020 London, it's pretty inescapable if you're following real world history to avoid what's going on. But I've heard a few mixed things about this one actually, but I am interested to try it for myself. The odd thing being it has Tom Baker as his curator character, which is pretty cool. So the four stories are Lost Property, Wild Animals, Must See TV, and Divine Intervention. It is in the fat box style, so no individual CDs unfortunately, but yeah, nice to own Stranded One, a set that's so new. And last but not least, we have three more sets here going back into the Time War, starting with this, Doctor Who, the Eighth Doctor, the Time War 2. Again, the Volume 1 curse hits here. There is no Volume 1, which is a shame. But ever since the Eighth Doctor range started with the Time War, I've been wanting to delve into this because the Time War is just such a fascinating, like, part of Who history. I'm currently going through the War Doctor series and loving it. So Time War 2 is here with the logo that I'm not particularly a fan of, but that does change. So Time War 2 has four stories. You've got the Lords of Terror, Planet of the Ogrons, In the Garden of Death, and Jonah, which is really cool. So yeah, when I do get Volume 1, I'm actually really excited to delve into the Eighth Doctor Time War adventures. And to make sure I continue that, we have the Eighth Doctor Time War Volume 3, which is really, really cool. You've got Michael Jaston there on the left of Paul McGann as the War Valyard, which sounds like a really interesting concept. I'll be really curious to dive into that, certainly. So this is Volume 3 with the new logo now, of course, the logo I prefer. And oh no, they've changed the spine. It doesn't matter really, does it? And you've got four stories. You've got State of Bliss, The Famished Lands, Fugitive in Time, and The War Valyard. And these are still in their own individual cases, as is Time War 2. So yeah, everyone gets their own cover. Everyone is happy. But of course, the final set, it would be fitting. It's the most up-to-date set. It is Doctor Who The Time War Volume 4. Now, at the time of recording this, this literally came out about a month ago, maybe even less than a month. So to get this at the price I did so soon is incredible, especially brand new factory sealed as well. You can see Davros is front and center using the model from the modern series, but then using the Terry Molloy Davros face, which I'm sure will be explained. You have four stories on here, just like the rest. I say that, three stories, because Palindrome, the first, is in two parts, part one and two. You've got Dreadshade and Restoration of the Daleks now, and there's your four CDs as well. Now, Big Finish typically do their box sets in volumes of four, so I doubt the Eighth Doctor Time War series is going to continue, although you never know, maybe at the end of the last one of Volume 4 they might leave something for a future, but they typically do them in sets of four. So again, shame Volume 1 is not here, but I'm quite happy with all that. So that, dear friends, are the 13 sets I managed to get in this rather huge Big Finish bundle. Really, really happy with this, comprising of, you know, some First Doctor, a whole lot of Eighth Doctor, which is really cool, some sets from Gallifrey, some River Song sets, and the first installment of the Churchill Years. So that is a pretty impressive haul, if I do say so myself. Now, I'm sure what a lot of you want to know is, how much did I pay for all of this? So the total cost I paid for this was £105, which does sound like a lot to a lot of people. However, you've got to put things into perspective. When you divide 105 by 13, you get 8.333 recurring. So say roughly £8.33 per box set, which is actually pretty good for what you get in. Because a lot of these, when they go on Big Finish new, they can range from anywhere from £25 up to £40 new, like this sealed as well. So how much did I save? Well, dear friends, I went on the Big Finish website and had a look at all of these new. You can still buy all these new on CD. And the rough total cost of all of these new on CD was a whopping £468. You could take 13p off because they were all ending 99, but I rounded up for sake of ease. So £468, which means I made a saving of £363. Yeah. Which I think is probably the best haul of anything I've ever done. I've hauled a lot of things in my time, but to save that much money across this many releases is just staggering. So yeah, I saved over £350 picking all this up, which is mad. Again, I'm not saying I don't support Big Finish. I do like to buy from Big Finish or pre-order from them when I can. But realistically, you know, myself, like a lot of people, especially at this time, aren't made of money. So we're saving while we can. And the fact I've saved over £350 is amazing. For me, at least, that's an amazing achievement. And I'm dead happy with this haul. I've got a whole breadth of different kinds of Doctor Who to listen to, and I'm very excited to see what these adventures have in store. But that is the big Finish haul for this video. Please let me know if you enjoyed it. If you did, leave a like on this video, and let me know in the comments, do you enjoy any of these sets? Do you own them? Are there any sets you'd recommend that I listen to? Please subscribe to the channel if you're brand new, and until the next one, I'll see you guys next time. A massive thank you to our producer and director patrons for your support towards us here at AMTV. You just help keep us going, and that's massively appreciated. And that does bring us to the end of another evening here on AMTV. We hope you enjoyed the programme, and we hope to see you next time. Good night.